With Sheehan syndrome, also sometimes called postpartum pituitary gland necrosis, postpartum refers to the time after a mother gives birth to an infant. Pituitary gland refers to a tiny gland that is at the base of the brain, and necrosis refers to death. So postpartum pituitary gland necrosis is a disorder where the cells in a pituitary gland of a new mother start to die, most commonly because of excess blood loss during childbirth that leaves those cells without adequate blood flow. It's a rare type of pituitary apoplexy. During pregnancy, a group of cells in the pituitary gland called lactotrophs start to increase in size and number. These lactotrophs secrete the hormone prolactin, and the increased levels of prolactin prepares the mammary glands to produce milk. Even though there are more lactotrophs that are larger and more metabolically active, the blood supply of the pituitary gland remains the same, so there is this increased blood demand without an increase in supply, making the lactotrophs hypoperfused. In other words, the lactotrophs are just barely getting enough oxygenated blood, and they will become ischemic and die if blood flow is reduced further. Since there are more metabolically active lactotrophs around, they take up a larger proportion of the blood that supplies the pituitary gland. This increases the risk of ischemia in the other cells of the pituitary gland as well. During the delivery of an infant, some mothers can experience excessive blood loss, which is called postpartum hemorrhage. Postpartum hemorrhage is generally defined as losing more than 500 milliliters of blood after a vaginal delivery or more than 1,000 milliliters of blood after a cesarean section delivery. When this happens, there's less blood flowing to the cells of the pituitary gland. Coupled with the increased demand for blood by the lactotrophs, the pituitary cells no longer receive enough oxygen to survive, resulting in ischemic necrosis. If blood flow isn't restored soon, more and more cells in the pituitary die, and the pituitary gland progressively shrinks, becoming scarred, and stops producing enough of one or more hormones. In severe cases, severe destruction and scarring can lead to an empty cella turcica, which is when the pituitary gland shrinks and flattens into the skull. Increased cell death within the pituitary also means that a number of hormone levels start to fall. This includes growth hormone, adrenocorticotropic hormone, which acts on the adrenal gland, thyroid-stimulating hormone, which acts on the thyroid, and the gonadotropins, luteinizing hormone, and follicle-stimulating hormone, which act on the ovaries. Sheehan's syndrome results in hypopituitarism, a deficiency of the pituitary gland, and the symptoms are all related to a decrease in the various pituitary hormones. A classic early symptom of Sheehan syndrome is agalactorrhea, which is not being able to make as much breast milk or none at all because of a lack of prolactin. Later symptoms include amenorrhea, an absence of normal menstruation cycle, even after a period of lactation, which is due to a lack of luteinizing hormone and follicle-stimulating hormone. Sheehan syndrome can also cause hypothyroidism, which can cause low blood pressure, cold intolerance, and weight gain. It can also lead to low adrenocorticotropic hormone levels and a subsequent adrenal gland insufficiency, caused by a decrease in sodium and blood glucose levels. Low growth hormone can lead to fatigue and loss of muscle mass. In some women, the damage to the pituitary is relatively mild, so they have relatively normal levels of prolactin, and they don't have troubles with breastfeeding. Instead, they might notice the other symptoms months to years after their delivery. Sheehan's syndrome is typically diagnosed by measuring the pituitary hormone levels, which usually fall depending on the severity of the ischemic necrosis. In addition, MRI and CT scans can show a ring enhancement or halo around a partially or completely empty cella turcica, called a pituitary ring sign. Sheehan's syndrome can be treated by replacing the deficient hormones, and typically they're needed for a person's entire life. All right, as a quick recap, in pregnancy, the pituitary cells are getting just enough blood to survive because the lactotrophs increase in size and number, taking up more blood than usual. In Sheehan's syndrome, postpartum hemorrhage causes lactotrophs and other cells of the pituitary to die, resulting in low levels of prolactin, growth hormone, thyroid-stimulating hormone, adrenocorticotropic hormone, luteinizing hormone, and follicle-stimulating hormone. An early symptom is agalactorrhea, whereas late symptoms include amenorrhea, low blood pressure, low blood sodium, low blood glucose levels, as well as fatigue and muscle loss.
Thanks for watching. If you're interested in a deeper dive on this topic, Take a look at osmosis.org, where we have flashcards, questions, and other awesome tools to help you learn medicine. Otherwise, you can always support us by donating on Patreon, subscribing to our channel, or following us on social media.